How are you all?
In last class, we dealt about xylem, right? So in this class, we'll deal with the food pipe, that is phloem. Phloem is nothing but the pipeline which carries food, right? So what it is, transport food materials, usually from the leaves to other parts of the plant. Now in leaves only photosynthesis is going on, right? Even stems, though the stems which are green, photosynthesis is going on. So from leaves, the food materials, the stored food material is passed to different parts of the plant because of the phloem, right? Now phloem in gymnosperm is of different types: sieve tube elements, companion cells, phloem parenchyma, phloem fibers. Now, especially in gymnosperm, it is present albuminous cells and sieve cells. There is no sieve tube and companion cell. That is the difference between angiosperm and gymnosperm. In gymnosperm, there is no sieve tube and companion cell. So this shows that angiosperm is developed one, right? Now, first one is sieve tube elements. Now what it is nothing but a long tube-like structure arranged longitudinally and are associated with companion cells. So sieve tube elements are always connected with the companion cell. We'll see the reason also. The end walls are perforated, that means holes are there, in a sieve-like manner to form sieve plates. Okay, so there are small holes, perforations in the sieve plates. Mature sieve element possesses a peripheral cytoplasm and a large vacuole. There is no nucleus, so there is no control over its own cell. So nucleus of companion cell controls the function of sieve tube elements. That is why sieve tube elements are always connected with the companion cell. Now the companion cells. Specialized parenchymatous cells which are closely associated with sieve tube elements. So it is very important point. Sieve tube elements and companion cells are connected by pit fields. So both of them are connected, and that is why the companion cells nucleus is controlling the sieve tube elements. This companion cells help in maintaining pressure gradient in sieve tubes. So see the function of companion cell. It is not only controlling the sieve tubes, it is also helping in the controlling of pressure gradient, which is formed due to the movement of food materials in the sieve tubes, right? Now comes phloem parenchyma. It is elongated one, tapering cylindrical cells. Okay, that means pointed on two sides. It has dense cytoplasm with nucleus. The cell wall consists of cellulose, and even here also pits present through which the plasmodesmatal connections exist between the cells. Okay, so phloem parenchyma are connected to each other with the plasmodesmata. Okay, and its main function, see, always remember parenchyma does the storage function also. So here also it stores food materials. Also it stores other substances like resins, latex and mucilage, right? Phloem parenchyma is absent in monocotyledons. So that is a very important point because it is present in dicots. Now comes phloem fibers, which is otherwise known as bast fibers, right? It is clearenchymatous, that means the cell wall is much more thickened, right? It is found in secondary phloem and absent in primary phloem. That means first formed phloem is primary phloem, where it is absent, and in secondary phloem it is present, right? The sterile structure is, it is elongated one, unbranched, have and pointed needle like apex pieces, that means the pointed tips. The cell wall is very thick, that is why sclerenchymatous. Okay, at maturity these fibers lose their protoplasm and become dead. So mechanical function they are doing because they are dead. Okay, phloem fibers, especially we can use it as like jute, flax, hemp. These are the material we are using. So these are all phloem fibers. As I told you, first form phloem is protophloem, which consists of narrow sieve tube, and later formed phloem is metaphloem, which is bigger, having bigger sieve tubes. See the structure of phloem. this is what the sieve pore, this is the sieve tube elements. As I told you, it has perforations on the end plates forming the sieve pore. Okay, and this is the phloem parenchyma, this one is a phloem parenchyma, and this is the companion cell which is always attached with the sieve tubes. So sieve tube, companion cell, and the phloem parenchyma, right? So this is the structure of phloem, right? This is a tubular structure which takes the food materials from the leaf to different parts of the body. The sieve tube is controlled by companion cells nucleus, right? Even it is maintaining the pressure gradient in the sieve tubes, right? And phloem parenchyma is mainly meant for storage of food.
So thank you for watching. Bye.